सो दीज आर इनटेक्स क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन स्पीड एंड वेलोसिटी. सो आई हैव रिटन हियर, स्पीड इज रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ डिस्टेंस पर यूनिट टाइम, पर यूनिट टाइम विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम, यू हैव टू राइट दीज. एंड वेलोसिटी इज रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सो यू कैन सी वेयर इज द डिफरेंस, डिस्टेंस हियर इन केस ऑफ स्पीड एंड वेलोसिटी हियर इन केस ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट. स्पीड इज अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी व्हिच मींस इट डजंट हैव डायरेक्शन, वेलोसिटी इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी व्हिच मींस इट हैज अ डायरेक्शन. सो मूविंग ऑन टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अंडर वॉट कंडीशन एवरेज वेलोसिटी बिकम्स इक्वल टू स्पीड. So when the object moves along a straight line, then average velocity becomes equal to average speed. Question number 3. What does odometer? So odometer on a vehicle measures distance covered by the vehicle in a given time. Distance covered. So that's all. Question number 4. What does path of an object look like when it is in uniform motion? So rather than path, you write down distance time graph. Will look like a straight line, but with straight line passing through origin. Okay, so you can draw a small graph as well, but you will have to label it that this is distance and this is time. So it is a straight line which is passing through origin. During an experiment, a signal from the spaceship reached the ground station in 5 minutes. So first quantity is given is 5 minutes. What was the distance of the spaceship? Distance is asked and speed is this 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So you can see I have noted down the quantities. 5 minutes, time is given as 5 minutes, so note down change into seconds. So minute will be changed into second by multiplying into 60, so it is these many seconds, this is 300 seconds, right? What is to be found is distance. They have asked what was the distance of the spaceship. Okay, speed of light is given, though we should learn speed of light is 3 lakh, okay, or 3 × 10⁸ meter per second, 3 lakh kilometer per second or 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So now we will simply use speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance will be equal to speed into time. Put speed which is this and put time which is 300 second and you will be able to get the answer, multiply using mathematics, and you will be reporting the answer in meter because they have asked distance. Now set number next. In text question of the same chapter, next set. First question, what is the nature of distance time graph for uniform and non-uniform motion? So you can see S for distance, T for time. First of all, you will do the labeling of the graph. S for distance, T for time. So if it is a uniform motion, then it will be a straight line passing through origin. And if it is a uniform non-uniform motion, it will be a curved line. Okay, S for distance, T for time. So distance time graph will be a curved line. Question number 2. What can you say about the motion of objects whose distance time graph is a straight line parallel to time axis? So, it's an important question. Here, distance time graph, you can see I've drawn the graph. Distance time graph is a straight line parallel to time axis. That means, see, if distance time graph is parallel to this time axis, that means distance everywhere is 70, 70, 70. That means distance is not changing, position is not changing. So, I've written here position is fixed. That is the object is at rest. So if your distance time graph is parallel to time axis, it means object is at rest, there is no motion in it. Question number 3. So first we will read the question and then we will go to the answer. So you can see question is, what can you say about the motion of an object when a speed time graph is a straight line? So this time it is speed and time graph. S is not speed, S is always distance. So in previous question it was distance. Speed time graph is a straight line parallel to time axis. That means now speed is fixed. Earlier I wrote that position is fixed, distance is fixed. Now speed is fixed. It means it is representing uniform motion. Now question number 12. Fourth. Question number 4th is, what is the quantity which is measured by area occupied by velocity time graph? So you can see velocity time graph. Suppose this is the curve. So which quantity is represented by area under the graph? Which quantity is represented? Area means it is a product of length into breadth. Length axis is your velocity. So, write here velocity. And base axis is your time. So, you can write here. Now, you all know velocity is equal to displacement upon time. So, velocity into time will give you displacement. So, I have written here displacement. So, what is the answer? Area under velocity time graph will be giving you displacement. Area under velocity time graph will be giving you displacement. Now, moving on to the next set of question. So you can see now in this question, Let us see in this question, in next question. What will you say a body is in uniform? When will you say a body is in uniform acceleration and non-uniform? So if velocity increases by equal amounts in equal intervals of time along a straight line, every piece of statement is important. By equal amounts, velocity is increasing by equal amounts in equal time. This is important. Along a straight line, because acceleration is a vector quantity, so you must write along a straight line. If velocity is increasing by equal amounts in equal intervals of time, then it is uniform acceleration. And if it is increasing by unequal amounts, okay, then it is non-uniform acceleration. But you have to write everything, like fixed straight path, along a straight line, like that, because it is a vector quantity. A bus decreases its speed from 80 km per hour, it means it is initial velocity, to 60 km per hour, it means this is final velocity. The symbol for initial velocity is U, symbol for final velocity is V. Time is given as 5 seconds, so please note down time as well. Because it was in kilometer per hour, so I changed the time into hours, okay. How did I change? I divided by 60 first, now it is in minute, I have divided it again by 60, so now it is in hours, okay. So they have asked acceleration, find acceleration. So I know acceleration is change in velocity by time, so I have written here V for final velocity, U for initial velocity by time. So V and U and time I have put, this 60 will go up, okay, 60 into 60, so it will go up. Now you can simply calculate and you can report the answer in kilometer per hour square. Usual unit is meter per second square, but that is SI unit. But here everything was given in kilometer and hour, so my unit is going to be kilometer per hour square. Going to the next question, let us see the statement from here. Question number 3. A train starting means initial velocity is 0. If it is written somewhere that it is starting from rest, okay, that means initial velocity is 0, so by U is 0. And then it attains a speed of 40 km per hour, so this is final speed, final velocity, and time is 10 minutes. So let us write down all the quantities. It is starting from rest. Starting means initial velocity is 0, initial velocity is denoted by U, and final velocity that it attains is 40 km per hour. Time is given 10 minutes, so again I will convert into hours. Now minute to hours means you will divide only by 60. In previous question, time was given in seconds, so I divided twice by 60. So acceleration is to be found. Acceleration formula is V minus U by T. V for final velocity, U for initial velocity, and by time. So substitute your final velocity, substitute initial velocity, and time. Do mathematics properly. You will get the answer in kilometer per hour square. But if they are asking in any question, if they are asking the answer in SI unit, then how to change kilometer per hour square? Okay. Kilometer will be changed like multiply by 1000. Now it is in meters, hai na? This is the way why we convert kilometer into meters. Now hour square will be changed into like this. First minute, then second hour, first minute, and then second. So this is how you will calculate. Divide it, you will get the answer in meter per second. Otherwise, you can leave your answer in this if examiner is not asking. Getting to question number 1. A bus starting from rest. So you can see I have wrote it down U is equal to 0 because it is starting from rest. Okay, now going to it's given, acceleration is given 0.1 meter per second square. So I've noted down acceleration. Then it is given time is 2 minutes. 2 minutes, so I will immediately convert into second by multiplying. Minute is converted into second by multiplying by 60. What have they asked? Just observe it carefully. What have they asked? They have asked speed acquired. That is, they are asking final velocity. Final velocity is asked. So when final velocity is asked, you simply use first equation of motion. Why should you use first equation of motion? Because U is given, A is given, T is given. So yes, this is the best equation to be used. Okay, then they are asking distance traveled. Distance is denoted by S. Now you think which equation you can use. If you wish to use third equation, you can use that also because you are ready with V from first part, or you can use second equation also if you have time. Yes, time is there. This is the time. So you can use this equation also or third equation also. But mathematics you have to do. Now, question number 2. In question number 2, let us go through. A train is traveling at speed of 90 km per hour. So this is initial velocity. See, now I have converted into kilometer per hour. Kilometer per hour can be converted into meter per second by multiplying with 5 by 18. 18 5s are 90. So I have written 25 meter per second. This is my initial velocity, which is denoted by U. Now, ब्रेक्स आर अप्लाइड तो ऑब्वियसली इट विल स्टॉप, है ना, बिकॉज इट इज स्टॉपिंग. सो फाइनल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो एंड एक्सेलरेशन इज गिवन इन नेगेटिव, मीन्स इट इज रिटार्डेशन, मीन्स वेलोसिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग. ओके, इट विल स्टॉप ऑब्वियसली, स्टॉपिंग मीन्स रिटार्डेशन. क्वेश्चन इज हाउ फार इट विल गो, दैट इज डिस्टेंस इज आस्क्ड. नाउ यू सी विच इक्वेशन विल बी यूज, यू इज देयर, वी इज देयर, ए इज देयर, एस इज आस्क्ड. सो दीज ऑल वेरिएबल्स कम इन थर्ड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन. सो इट इज बेस्ट टू यूज दिस इक्वेशन, वी इज देयर, यू इज देयर, ए इज देयर. यू कैन सिंपली डू योर मैथमेटिक्स, सिंपल मैथमेटिक्स, एंड यू विल गेट योर डिस्टेंस एज दिस. ओके, नाउ गेटिंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, या फोर्थ क्वेश्चन इज हियर एज वेल, सो वी कैन डायरेक्टली सी फ्रॉम हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, या so we have not done, I think, question number 3 as well. So let us do question number 3 first. A trolley while going down inclined plane has an acceleration of 2 cm per second square. So this is acceleration. What will be the velocity after 3 seconds after the start? Look, start word is written, so I have taken my initial velocity as 0. Okay, assuming it is starting from rest. Acceleration was given. It was given 2 cm per second square. So I don't like centimeter. It should be converted into meter. So I have divided by 100, so now it is in meter per second square. Okay, time initial velocity is given 0, final velocity is asked. What will be the velocity after 10 seconds? It means time is given. So which equation should be used? A is there, U is there, T is there, and V is asked. So first equation should be used. You can put the quantities. Okay, do the mathematics, you will get the answer.